Good evening, everyone. After a lot of deliberation at the piano, we decided that 6:28 is okay to start the welcome because then the music will start by 6:30. I want to welcome you all this evening to the Chester High School Christmas concert. A little bit about what we're wearing. On the first week of school, when we came back from summer vacation, I had found myself kind of falling into this end of career funk. And I was really trying to figure out what was going on. And I thought, I think we've lost touch of the fun. We became so much about contest and judges and results. And I thought, that is not how I'm going to end here. We're gonna come back and we're gonna have some fun. So it's been a fun marching season, kind of low pressure. We had fun getting ready for basketball. We had fun putting together the Christmas concert, even though every now and then I still do regress back to that tyrant that many of you know and remember and loved from your time here. But that's all beside the point. So we get ready for the concert. And I said, here's what I want. I want to wear Christmas sweaters. Now the word ugly might have come out of my mouth, but then I said, but you know, let's just call them Christmas sweaters because ugly or beauty is in the eye of the beholder. So my sweater, my mom bought for me. So we're not gonna let her see this intro, but I wore it once at her house and it's been in my closet for 15 years. So tonight is the night that it's making its grand debut. Now, I am a nutcracker collector and that is why she bought this, but the kids have so noticed that there are three very distinct nutcrackers. There's this calm guy, this guy who's losing his mind, and the guy that doesn't seem to really care over here. And they go, that's you, Mr. Girl. This is you as we're getting ready for the concert. This is you today, and this will be you tomorrow. So here we are. I do again want to thank you. We're going to keep it relatively short. We worked on some stuff. I narrowed it down and ended up with three pieces from each group. We'll have a little bit of talking between each group for some setup. We're going to take our collection for the food pantry between concert choir and swing choir. And then we'll have the kids come up and do their thing that I dread every year. And then we'll end with band. We have had just an amazing turnaround here in the building. If you haven't taken the time to kind of look around at the changes and the things that are going on in the building, there's a lot of really nice things going on to make the building inviting and welcoming and nice to come into. And so I'm really excited about that. And we've just got more things coming as we go. So it's been a great year. It's been a great start to a year. And we're gonna have a lot of fun tonight. And I'm gonna have you out of here in 45 minutes. Promise.
Did I just hear, yeah, right? Is that what I heard?
Mary, not a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do.
Don't want a doll.
No dinky tinker toy.
I want a hippopotamus to play with and enjoy. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. I don't think Santa Claus will mind to you. He won't have to use our dirty chimney flue. Just bring him through the front door, that's the easy thing to do.
I can see me now on Christmas morning, creeping down the stairs.
Oh, what joy and what surprise when I open up my eyes to see
a hippo hero standing there. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do.
I only like hippopotamuses,
and hippopotamuses like me too.
Mom says a hippo would eat me up and then.
Teacher says the hippo is a vegetarian.
Lots of room for him in our two-car garage. I feed him there and wash him there and give him his massage.
I can see me now on Christmas morning, creeping down the stairs.
Oh, what joy and what surprise when I open up my eyes to
see a hippo hero standing there. I want a hippopotamus for Christmas. Only a hippopotamus will do.
I only like hippopotamuses,
and hippopotamuses like me too.
All right, as we, sorry, this is really hot. As we get ready here to set up for swing choir, I've got some seniors with me to come around. This is an every year thing. This is something that I hope to like put out there as I fade away and the next person comes in here to make sure that this kind of thing keeps going. For years and years and years, we collected food items at the concert. And it was always kind of the same thing. Everybody was like, oh, I forgot. And so we started about, I guess, 10 years ago. Go ahead and start over. We started about 10 years ago taking a collection at our concerts as a means of helping out the Chester Area Christian Food Pantry. Go ahead, go. Go. I promise 45 minutes and you're gonna spend 10 minutes standing here while I tell a story. But we started this about 10 or so years ago after having spoken with Bob Koenigstein, who is kind of the spearhead at the food pantry. And he said, honestly, Steve, we can do as much more with a dollar than the average shopper can. So the buying power of our dollars are much greater if we just give cash. And so they can fill in the gaps. You know, they're still using the money or the collection from the Boy Scouts from the Scouting for Food the week before Thanksgiving. So they still have that inside their food pantry. And they take this cash and they fill in the gaps so that they can make sure that everyone gets nice meals for both Thanksgiving and Christmas. A lot of times our money goes in and helps them replenish and restock to get ready for the winter because, you know, we think, oh, Christmas and Thanksgiving, that's when people need food, need to be helped out. And the fact is, hunger doesn't know a season. So, you know, it's one of those things that is ongoing, and it's going to be one of the things after I retire that I am going to continue working with the food pantry. It's going to be one of my, aside from the Christmas chaos, again, out on Cold Place Road, the next thing in my heart is that Christmas and the food pantry and helping them out. So that's going to be one of the big things that I continue doing in my time. So as the buckets are going around, and we'll make sure that they get everywhere they need to, if you don't see a bucket, it doesn't come by you, they'll be down here in front after the concert and come down and, you know, and Listen, if all you've got in your wallet is a $50 bill, I'm not telling you to put the $50 bill in there. You come down here, we'll break it for you, do whatever, you tell us how much change you want back. If you want $49, I'm not going to judge. Much. Just kidding, I won't judge. So just come on down and we can break a large bill for you or whatever it can buy you. I appreciate all that goes into this yearly. One last thing we're going to do, we're going to be out at our house collecting next weekend. I'm hoping for warm weather. It's been warm all season. It'll probably be 20 below zero next weekend. A cold front will swing in and it will rain. Not freezing rain, not snow, just rain and cold. So that'll be what happens while we're out there. So thank you so much for your generosity. I believe we are set. I'm just about ready to go. Now, we practiced today and there was no barrier here. And then I put this blue cord down. So all of these people over on this side are very nervous about this blue cord. Watch your step. No.
Four more days of being lonely. Three more wishes I Hi, everybody. My name is Isaiah Rock, and I'm from Manchester High School.
I'm Hannah Kimpy. I'm also a senior.
Every year, we get a kernel something special just to celebrate the season, and it comes from the seniors and the whole band. To start off, if you see Colonel's Facebook, he's always at a Broncos game, and if you see him in the hallways, he always has a pair of Crocs on. So, we decided to put those together and give him some Cardinals Crocs.
Which are coming out right
now! We hope to see you wearing these.
Yes, you have to come see the pajama game in March, because the thing that people don't realize is that musicals are not cheap. And so by the time you pay your royalties and you rent all the materials, and we're bringing back a live orchestra again, so by the time we do all of that, we're in the hole about $3,000 before we've set a set piece on the stage or bought a costume or done anything like that. So we're counting on three good nights, August 14th, or April, August. I'm just trying to get to summer. March 14th, 15th, and 16th. It'll be in Jurgen's Gym, and it's gonna be a really fun time. That's a quirky little show. If you don't know it, look it up. The movie version, Star Doris Day and John Raitt. But it's gonna be a lot of fun, and I look forward to that in the spring. And then I look forward to some time off after that. So thank you so much, and we're gonna get on.
Thank you.
So, you know, what we don't talk about is this concert for this group is the hardest thing we do all year, because we come out of football season where we spent the whole entirety of 9 or 10 or 12 weeks plus summer telling them, you need to play louder, you need to be louder, you're outside, you gotta be louder, 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 then we come inside, I gotta be quieter. And it's really hard to transition that. And about the time that I get them convinced that we need to be quieter, then basketball starts. And we're back to loud. And then it's loud and soft. Today we're gonna be loud and tomorrow and soft. But this has just been, it's been a joy this year. The fun is back. I don't know about them, but it is for me. I'm enjoying what we're doing. And it's just been, it's been really, really fun to get ready for this. And I don't tell them how good they are, because my number one philosophy in this world is never believe your own press. You know, don't ever let yourself believe that you've arrived, because once you arrive, you have no place to go. So we're always, always, always pushing to be better than the last time, and it's every performance better than the last. Our last song is my favorite piece. Each year we kind of pick apart a different spot that I really want to focus on to make it better. And they really dug in. I made them turn their music around and play from memory about a week ago. And as soon as I said, turn your music around, the look on their face, you thought I asked them to chop off their right arm and throw it at their neighbor. But they did, and then they instantly realized, hey, we can actually play this. And so it's been much, much better since then. But again, thank you so much for coming out tonight. It is so nice to have nice audiences. We took a lot of things for granted, and then 2020 came along and we were hit with a grim reality that we can't take anything for granted. So it's great to have a live audience. It's great to have a nice audience. Goodness gracious, I'm tired that I said that again. Thank you again tonight. It has been a joy. So, sleigh ride. Thank you.
Thank you.